Hello students, welcome to Saurabh Sir's classes. So in today's video we'll be solving MA Economics 2012 entrance exam paper. So we are solving Hyderabad Central University question paper from MA Economics exam. So in today's video we'll be solving question number 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. So we'll be solving this 5 question. So first I'll start with question number 16. So it is given Ricardo's theory of comparative advantage is based on 4 options are given: the opportunity cost theory, the law of diminishing return, the labor value theory of value, and all of the above. We know the opportunity cost theory because if you consider 2 countries, say 5, 6, 7, 8. So now if it is country B and if this country A, now, and this is the labor needed to produce, and this is the labor needed to produce a same amount of quantity. So as you can see, for country A, the labor needed for production of A for X commodity is less, and for Y commodity is also less in country A. So country A has absolute advantage over 7 and 8. But still, Ricardian theory basically talks about the trade. Even after this, the trade could take place because the opportunity cost of these 2 countries are different. So for this, we have to just divide 5 by 7 and 6 by 8. Then from there, we can write the opportunity cost of one country is more than another country. So whose opportunity cost is more, that country will simply import that commodity. So we would conclude the Ricardian theory of comparative advantage is based on opportunity cost theory. So now we'll go to the next question, which is the Human Development Index question. It is a measure that combines 4 options are given. So for question number 16, we have found the right answer to be option A. Now for question number 17, Human Development Index is a measure that combines, we know, it combines life expectancy, for sure, combines life expectancy, educational attainment, sure, and per capita income. So this is the right answer. It seems to be the option C is the right answer, that is Human Development Index, which we call as name as HDI, includes life expectancy, educational attainment, and per capita GDP. So for option 17, I'll say option C is the right answer. I'll be giving you a couple of seconds to grasp these 2 questions and the answer, to go through it for a couple of seconds before we move on to the other parts of this video. So I hope you guys have grasped the concept of these 2 questions. Now we'll go to the next section of this video, where we'll solve the other 3 questions which we have aimed to solve in this video. So question number 18, 19 and 20. So question number 18 is given as the functions of Finance Commission explicitly includes, 4 options are given: distribution of net proceeds of tax between center and state, distribution of grants in aid to the states, advise state finance commissions, and seek resources to local bodies, and all of the above. So the job of finance commission explicitly includes the distribution of net proceed of tax between center and state, to be divided as per their respective contribution to the tracks. So it's conclude that for Finance Commission explicitly focuses on distribution of net proceeds of tax between center and, so the net proceeds of tax between center and state is the job of Finance Commission. So now we'll go to the next option question, which is question number 9. So for question number 9, the question goes like this: which of the following statement is true about the median as a measure of central tendency? So a value of median is less than the sampling fluctuations in the arithmetic mean. It is possible to determine the combined median of two or more sample groups. It is easy to calculate. It is not necessary to arrange the data in a particular order. The median is recommended over mean if the distribution and unequal class intervals. So from here we can say for question number 19, option B is the right answer. That is, it is possible to determine the combined median of two or more sample groups. So we can determine the combined median of two and more sample groups. So for question number 19, the right answer is option B. That is, which of the following statement is true about the median as a measure of central tendency? Option B, which says it is possible to determine the combined median of two or more sample groups. So for question number 19, option B is the right answer. Now we'll go to the next question, which says angel curve for a given good is, four options are given. So we conclude angel curve for a given good is always negatively sloped. Is always negatively slope. Why? Because we know so angel curve basically shows the relationship between money income and quantity consumed. Now for normal good, when the price of normal good increases, when the income of the consumer increases, it is quite expected he will consume more of that good. So we get a positively sloped curve. But for given good, when his income increases, he decreases the consumption of that good. So when his income increases, he decreases the consumption of that good. So we get the angel curve to be negatively sloped. So we conclude that for question number 20, option C is the right answer. So in today's video, we solve 3, 4, 5 questions. Question number 16, question number 17, question number 18, question number 19, and question number 20. For question number 16, the right answer was option A. For question number 17, it was C. For question number 18, it was A. For 19, it was B. For 20, it was C. So if you have any query or doubt regarding these questions, or if you want to know more about it, or if you have any suggestion or request regarding this question, so I'll be giving you my number, which is 9836793076. You can simply WhatsApp me on this number, or you can also go to our website, which is www.showropsersclasses.com. There you will find a lot of other videos like this, and you will also get materials for the economics entrance exam for different universities. So thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day ahead.